This is year six since I've been here, and I think Dawson's had a history of all first divisions for a very, very, very long time, which is not really common everywhere. And I mean, I was talking to the guy who does the videos on the way down, said how much he enjoyed the show and how great you guys are. And I said, yeah, they're amazing kids. They've worked really hard this season. He said he's good. You enjoyed it. He said it's not like that everywhere. And I mean, I completely agree. Like, we have just a special thing here with us, where not only are we, you know, making first divisions, but I mean, we're creating great shows, great performances that people really enjoy watching. I mean, I've just heard nothing but compliments from you guys all the way down since like y'all finished your show. Congratulations. I think, like I talked to y'all today, our focus now needs to shift to next week. I think we need to live in the moment and be very proud of this, because this is not something everybody gets to enjoy. But I think we also need to look to what this means for us next week. Next week's going to be a very, very big week. So lots of work. I meant to tell you, I had a conversation with somebody who watched the show who went on and on about how clean some of the stuff was in part two. I said, wow, it wasn't like that last night. So compliments to you all. The point being that the work that we did today showed up tonight, like, and that was great because we didn't spend a lot of time. It was just some reminders on what to do, and then absolutely done. So congratulations, a great job on that. Compliments on the Mozart specifically about how it's played and performed, and a lot of people are starting to not only see the show, but like the things we talk about and like how the music has to be performed so that we see a musical journey that's showing up with people that see the show, which is not, again, not common. It's something that's really, really special for you guys. So you should be very proud of this. You should be very proud of your performance, and I hope y'all are excited about moving forward this week and hopefully having a great set of shows next week too, okay? That's it. Woo! Congratulations.
Well, Connect Four is super simple. It's, you know, four things that are connecting together. But I think the cool thing about our show is that we take it and we see it through everything. We've got four physical props on the field. We connect those through time. We've got four different colors that are representative to four different styles of music. So it's a really simple concept. It could also just mean something as simple as, like, you know, we work better together when we're connected as opposed to being pulled apart. So there's a lot of, it can be as simple as you want it to be. It can also be as in-depth as you want it to be. We start with something that feels a little bit more structured or familiar, and that's why we chose classical music at the very beginning. It's a style of music that our band program plays really, really well, and it's not usually as utilized in marching band as much. So we thought that starting with something classical, very familiar, then obviously we go into the tango. We start to get a little bit curvier, less straight lined, less rigid. Circle shapes, we add in the skirts from the color guard to create more movement. It's way more dynamic. We pull the props together. So we've got two sets of two props that have pulled together onto the field. The next part is obviously kind of the percussion interlude or section.
Now it should be up above the end zone. Very good, woodwinds. Mark these up, woodwinds. Here.
We kind of break up everything back up again. Brand new music, very modern, and then pull it all together into something that's going to be the most familiar, maybe to a student end, with the pop song, with the Daft Punk. Something to get the kids excited that are in other band programs, and then full circle it together at the end with something super powerful with the bolero. We'll be right back. Classical music takes you to a classical era. Purple kind of represents opulence, money, wealth, prosperity. So the purple really was like a regal color. And that's why that ultimately was chosen for the beginning. Then we chose that like pink fuchsia. Tango is inherent to the color red. Anytime you think or see a Spanish style tango, you're gonna think the color red. So we chose that pink fuchsia to coordinate with that. The minimalistic section and orange just felt like the right progression of color that was next. There is no necessarily like we chose orange because it was just whatever. It just felt like in a color story that that made sense. And when you think of pop, you think of bright, you think of, you just think of bright colors. So yellow seemed to fit perfectly as well. And we really liked the progression of those four colors as like almost like an ombre, if you will, of something darker to something lighter. So ultimately that's why we chose those four sections. I think if we hadn't done something classical at the beginning, that color story could have been completely different. But since it was super classical, purple was the right color and choice, and that kind of helped shed light onto the rest of the color palette for the show.
So being a soloist, it does put a lot of pressure on just like a few people at a time, especially like for me opening out the entire show. You know, I'm really careful to not like mess up at all because that kind of sets the opening mood for the entire show. But I think like overall, being a soloist also places me in like a really unique position to kind of experience things that, you know, other band members might not get to experience.
I agree with that. I really, really like the end where we're all just like, we're all four of us, the soloists, are on the prop like this and we're looking up at the audience and it's the end of the show, we're breathing hard, we're smiling. The sun is sometimes in our faces. It's just a really, really amazing moment. It's surreal, it really is. But again, it also does put a lot of weight on our shoulders, especially because this year the show revolves around the flute soloists. And if, say, one of us wasn't there, the show wouldn't be the same, it wouldn't be complete.
I play like two main solo parts. So once at the very beginning in the opener, it's not really a part of any of like the four styles of music that we explore. It's more of just like setting the scene for what's to come. So like that solo is very kind of smooth and like elegant. The other solo I have is in our pop movement, and I play like a really pop solo. It has features a lot of like pop music rhythms, a lot of syncopation, and that one's also really fun.
I play in the part four, and I play the minimalist piece. Out of the four genres, I play the minimalist, and it's just the same sequence of notes over and over and over and over and over again for 8 cycles. And during that time, it's basically just me and the percussion. And that's when the band can focus on marching, on timing, on looking uniform. And it's just very minimal, as the name suggests.
All right, we got a long day, I already said that. But I mean, we got a lot of momentum coming from this, I'm not gonna lie.
Area E is very, very, very difficult this year. Past years, we've had 5 spots, we have 4 this year. A lot of other bands have also stepped up their game a lot. Dickinson is really, really good. So is Clearbrook, so is SFA. There's 8 bands there that could potentially make state.
I'm not gonna lie, y'all surprised me. I said that last time, and you surprised me again.
The amount of improvement from this horn line has been actually insane.
I'd be on the field, I'd be hearing y'all, dang!
State is on the line, and as we know from 2 years ago, nothing is guaranteed.
1 second of someone not being focused is gonna cost us.
The moment we stop focusing, and the moment we stopped, like, this rehearsal was insanely focused. We were in the grind set for real. The moment we get out of that is the moment we don't make state.
Every one of the moments that we go through today has to be perfect.
Weeks of sweat, all that hype, grind, gone because of one mistake.
We all have to be locked in, because if we do, I think we're gonna be really happy going home tonight, okay?
When all y'all lock in, bro, I'm not even gonna lie, the sky's the limit, bro.
Right, there's a lot on the line tonight. But if there's any horn line that's gonna be able to make state, it's this one.
Yeah! Ski on me, ski on 3, 1, 2, 3, ski!
Today is a special day. Just like every day here in the Dawson Band is a special day, am I right?
Yeah! This is about you. This is not about anybody else but you.
You're very fortunate to have the staff that you have. They care about you so much.
And that's all I do. Every day I come to school, I tell these guys, just try to be better. Be a better person, be a better player, be a better teammate.
How many other organizations do you have where you have 30 people who are just completely different in every single way, different backgrounds, just different households, different interests, and that is all brought together by like a chunk of metal that you blow through every day? I mean, am I right? Like, it's really, really, it's very cool.
To find a place where the people that work with you daily care about each other and care about you more than anything, it's pretty rare.
We are here, and we are here for something that is bigger than just that chunk of metal for all of each individual person.
We all know that this is hard, and we all know that this isn't for everybody. And we all know that we've had people that have come through here, and somewhere along the way they've gone, I can't do this.
There were so many humps that we went through in the process of getting to where we are right now, where it was just like, I don't know what's going to happen.
If the odds do not fall in our favor, you will at least know what the effort felt like to shoot to get there.
Seniors, y'all have been an incredible senior class. Y'all have made the most significant impact of any senior class since I've been here. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. I thank you so much for letting me and for letting this program be a part of your life for these 4 years. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you feel like it's been worth it. So with that, seniors, get your dog tags.
The difference between UIL and BOA, I feel like UIL kind of appeals more so to the older type of marching band, where it's all about like, are your feet in time? Are you matching your drill? Are you getting your lines? Are you getting your diags? Can your ensemble play their music and can you play it well? I think BOA more so shines a light towards a whole entire production in terms of choreo, how your ensemble moves throughout the field, how your impact moments are. So I think BOA is more so production based. I think UIL is just more so, are you checking all the boxes of can your ensemble do the basic things of marching band? The first step is UIL region. Everyone in the state of Texas goes to UIL region. That's the first step you go to. So within that contest, you get rated 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. If you get rated a 1, that's superior. That means you did really well. If you get rated a 5, there's some things that you still need to work on within your production. So if you get a 1, if you get straight 1s, you get to go on to the next step, which is area marching contest. Area takes pretty much the surrounding areas of your region, brings those schools together, and they compete at a contest that is both a prelims and finals round. In prelims, they take the top 10 from prelims, and those people make it to area. And depending on how many people are within your area or make it to the area contest, from there they decide how many of those bands from area go to state. After that, you go on to state. And then at the state round, it's very similar to the area round, where there's a prelims and there's a finals, and they take the top 14 at finals, and then those are the people that take the cake and they select a winner from that. So that's the process for UIL. I think my biggest thing going into every single contest that we've had this whole entire semester is like, the Dawson Band just needs to give their all. They need to do their complete best and put their best foot forward, and they're gonna be completely fine in the end. So I think that's been the overall goal getting into region, and that's been my overall goal for any contest that we've had. for the past semester.
So we advanced to finals, so congratulations, everybody. Our prelims placement overall was second place. I don't know how y'all felt about your performance. I'm going to ask you some questions in just a second. The reality is that whatever we presented of us was very well received. I have not listened to all five of the judges' tapes just because I haven't had time. I listened to two of the music tapes, and they were all just very, very, very positive. They're like, wow, that's really good. Wow, that's really good. Wow, your style's really good. Wow, that's a great flute. Wow, wait, that's another great flute. Wait, there's another. Do y'all have? And then one guy even said, he's like, we got to the part four and we put all the flutes together. He's like, ah, said, I was going to ask if you had like one really good flute that just moved around or if you have four of them. So as we prep for tonight, some things that I think we need to concern ourselves with is that, number one, what we presented was really, really, really good, even if it wasn't as good as your run through was this morning. It's important that we keep that same attention to detail. It's important that nothing really changes outside of our norm. We've gotten this far because we haven't had heroes in our band program. We haven't had kids that feel like they need to save the world and start to do something weird in a performance. That needs to stay. Okay. Now what we do need to do is, and now that we're more comfortable, we do need to make sure that we're all at our volumes we're supposed to be at. We're all there for our friends and our neighbors and the people around us like we're supposed to be there for them. Okay. And that's all we need to do. You need to stay rested. The thing that I'm a little worried about, just because it's normal for kids, is for as we go through these next couple of hours, for you mentally to start to drain yourself and for you not to be mentally in it as we go through. We're early in the finals. That's not the best place to be. You're going to have to be fantastic in that third spot, right? It's Pearland is first, Clear Lake is second, and then it's Dawson. And then after that, there's seven other bands that were close to us in scores. We have to make sure that we're ready to go in that spot, okay? You with me?
Yes, sir.
You should be really, really proud of yourselves. And you should be excited to get to do this again in a more comfortable environment that you're more ready for, okay? Our order of operations now. You're going to have to get everything clean here.
From majors Janet Jean, James Powers, Isabella Ritchie, and Devin Salju, they begin your performance for the finals of the UIL Area E Marching Band Contest.
I was like really happy with our performance at area, like both in prelims and in finals. There weren't any like glaringly obvious mistakes. Everything that maybe needed to improve were just like little stuff that we'll keep working on this week as we make our push to state and to BOA San Antonio. The energy, especially like in finals, was definitely like heightened. And I think, yeah, overall the band did really well. And I was like happy with like my own personal performance and also like the entire band as a whole.
I also thought so. Me personally, I thought our finals performance was a little bit better than our prelims performance. I'm really proud of everyone. We were able to finish out the show strong. The energy was really great because everyone thought we did well in the finals performance and everyone was excited.
I thought the area contest went really well overall. Definitely an improvement from last year's area contest in all different aspects. The biggest thing that we needed to improve on was, I guess, one of the clinicians that we had from BOA said the math. And what that pretty much is achieving our drill sets, like our standard, like we talked about with what UIL focuses on. It's all about, are your lines, is your drill happening? Is your lines meeting? Is your diags happening? There was a lot of stuff within our show that our drill was not locking in the way it needed to lock in. So that's been the biggest thing that we need to continue to improve on. Of course, there's some other musical things, some minor musical things that we need to work on, like figuring out how to release our notes, which we're still trying to get on that, and just refining our sound as we go. I think overall, if you compare this year's UIL area run to last year's UIL area run, you would see a complete difference in how we sound and also how we look and how we move. But the biggest thing coming out of this weekend is just, let's lock into our dots, let's lock into our forms, and let's fix our math, our drill.
I felt pretty confident going into the award ceremony that we would advance to state. So I think there wasn't too much fear going into the placements of the bands being called. You know, looking at the other performances that we were able to watch in finals, I felt like it was pretty deserved, and I feel like it's a good motivation for us to kind of keep pushing throughout just like the last week of our season.
I was a bit worried. I'm not gonna lie, I was a little bit worried when they were announcing the bands. But I also did think we were gonna make state because we were so happy about our finals performance. But nonetheless, it was still nerve-wracking, and I still was holding hands with the people around me. Even though we knew that I felt like we knew we were gonna make finals, but there's always that risk that we're gonna get fifth, like we did that one year.
It's gonna be the same thing, and I think a lot of the kids are mad at me because I say this every single time, is like, I truly believe if we go onto that field and we do what we need to do, we do what we've been taught to do, and we just put our best foot forward, that's focused effort, I think the result is gonna be the result in it. As long as there's progress from what we've had in the past couple years, I will be completely happy. That's all I ask for. I'm not looking for finals. I don't care about finals. I don't want like a super high score, but if I see that there's been progress from last year up to this year, I'm a happy guy.
Again, like I was really happy. Honestly, that's going into area, that's all we can really hope for, is like for, you know, our hard work to be like well received, you know, by the audience and by the judges. But I feel like overall, even better than that, it's just like sharing the experiences with the people around me. Having a good performance and having something we were proud of at the end really means more than all of that. But again, still making state is obviously really great, and I'm really happy about that.